today we are going to perform exercise on plane table, and as you know there are four methods in plane table, so we are going to use a reception method of plane table. This method is particularly used to determine the positions of the plane table occupied by the user on the ground. Equipment which we use in this particular exercise is almost the same which we are using in other practicals: plane table and stand. We are using elevate. We are using tape, flat. We are using level and staff. In fact, level and staff, these are used later on for cutting purpose, but all other equipment we will use to determine the positions by the radiation method. Very simple principle which we use is, suppose there are three points A, B and C. These are known as the control points and their position is known to us. So we set up plane table at a station whose position is to be determined with the help of these three control points. So their plotted position is, let us say, small a, small b and small c. So we know the plotted positions of these three points on the plane table, and we want to find out the ground point P which has been occupied by the plane table on the plane table mat, on the sheet. So in radiation method, which is opposite to intersection method principle, that with the help of three known points, with the help of three plotted positions on the plane table, we have to find out the positions of the plane table occupied station. So what we do is same steps as we are doing in other methods. Number one step is the leveling. Plane table top should be leveled. Number two is orientation. The plane table is properly oriented. Normally we orient with respect to north. And the third will be, in that case, drawing rays. So I will explain you now how do you draw the rays, because these two steps are common and we already know, we are already aware about these steps. So we, with the help of elidate, what we do is that we keep the elidate at A point, we keep the elidate at A point and bisect point A. So we loosen the screw, try to rotate the top of the plane table so that small a and capital A are in one line. So when we have aligned them in one line, fix, clamp the position and extend this particular ray on the plane table. So this is called the orientation. I have oriented my plane table with respect to ground point A and its plotted position small a. Now the next job is that you have to keep the elidate at B point and try to bisect capital B on the ground. It is quite likely that this B point and capital B point, when you are keeping the elidate along this B and draw the rays, now they will cut at a point. So when you are keeping the elidate at B in such a way that capital B on the ground, small b on the ground, they are in one line, and you extend this line, it will cut at a point. So it is quite natural that two lines will always make an intersection and will give you a fine point. Now what we are going to do is, now we are keeping our elidate at C and bisecting ground points capital C, and then we are drawing the ray, extending our ray. So if our orientation is perfect, we may get a single point. But since our orientation is not perfect or we have a small error, so normally we get a triangle. Here these three rays will intersect and form a triangle. I make a bigger figure here now. This is my ray from B, this is my ray from C, and this is my ray from A. So I have ray from A, ray from B, and ray from C. So this particular triangle which is formed is called triangle of error. So what our objective is, what our aim is, that we have to reduce this triangle to a small point. And that small point I would like to call as a small p on the plane table. That means I have determined the ground point p as a small p on the plane table. So to solve this triangle of error, to reduce this triangle of error into a single point, what we do is now we will use well-known Lehmann rules. So there are three rules which will be used for solving this problem. So we will concentrate now on the Lehmann's rule. So there are three rules which will help us to solve this triangle and to get a single point. Rule one says that if you join point A, B and C, so this will make a triangle, and this is called a great triangle. So if the plane table position, if you are standing within this great triangle, the plane table position will be inside the triangle. So this is rule one. So rule one says that if the plane table is kept within the great triangle is a triangle joining the three control points on the ground. So your plotted position will always be within the triangle. Otherwise, if you are outside the triangle, as in this particular case, we are outside the triangle. If I join A, B and C, so this triangle is formed and we are outside the triangle. We are standing outside the triangle. So it says that if you are standing outside the triangle, your position will be outside this triangle. So outside this triangle, my position may be here, my position may be here, my position may be here, anywhere. So in this particular case, my position may be somewhere in this particular region. So this is rule number one. Rule number two. Rule two says that you have to now, if you have to reduce it to a single point, you have to use some kind of a coordinate geometry problem. So you have to select a point in such a way that if all the three rays are intersecting and this triangle is formed to the left side, the point will be on the left side. So here in this particular case, the triangle is formed on the left side. So here what it says that the point, which is, let us say, a small p point, this will always be on the left of all the three rays. So either a small p will be on the left side of all the three rays, or a small p will be on the right side of the three rays, depending upon the intersection of these three rays. So this is rule number two. And rule number three is that you have to select this point approximately in such a way so that if I draw perpendicular on these three rays, this AA rays, BB rays and CC rays, if I drop a perpendicular on these rays and this perpendicular distance is proportional to the distance from A, from B, and from C. In other words, if I write this as 1, this as 2, this as 3, and I write the intersection points also. So if I write the intersection point small c, small b, small a, so it will be something like P1 upon PA is equal to P2 upon PB is equal to P3 upon PC. So it will follow this geometrical relationship. So we have to select approximately so that it satisfies this criteria. It is in proportional to the distance of this point from A, B, and C. So if we are following these three rules, then it is very easy to convert this triangle into a smaller one. So when we are following rule 1, following rule 1, 2, and 3, maybe this happens is that this is our first trial and we get approximate position of a point P. So what is done here now, that once we get approximate position of P as P dash following these three rules. Now our next step will be that you have to keep the alidate at P dash and orient your table along PA. So now orientation is to be done along this direction. We got approximate position by first trial. So once I orient my table along P dash A, I extend this line on my plane table, and from plotted position of this point B, I again draw a ring. B, capital B. I again draw a ray from small c and capital C. So extend this line. So this time I should get a smaller triangle. So this is now indicates that our first attempt was successful if I get a smaller triangle. So now if I get a smaller triangle second time, we have to again follow these three rules and get approximate position now as P double dash. This, that means I am doing second attempt, second iteration. So same thing we have to repeat as we have done with the P dash. So after two or three iterations, we will find that we are able to get a point small p where all the three rays are intersecting at a common point and plane table is properly oriented along these three plotted positions. So it is quite likely maybe 3 iterations, maybe 4 iterations, but if we are following the correct procedure, we are likely to get in 2-3 attempts the actual point. So this is the point small p on plane table which has been occupied on the ground as capital P. So our aim is now that now here we have got a point which is small p. So once we got a small p and we know these three control points, now from this particular point we can use radiation method of plotting. So after getting this position, we can use, as we have done earlier also, now we can use from this point radiation method. That means we can plot the surrounding details by the method of radiation using the tape and getting the proper direction. So overall, in resection method, what we are doing is we are determining the plane table positions with the help of three known control points. This method is used to determine the position of the point occupied by the plane table, and once we know the position, then we can use radiation method. Of once we know this position and once we shift know another position, we can use intersection method. So resection method is only to determine the position. For plotting the details, we have to use either radiation method or intersection method. And now we will also use level and the staff. These instruments we will also use for plotting the details.